Well, hello. I am out here in front of, and I was inside, my Harbor Freight 10x12 greenhouse. The kit, I put it all together, one person. It took around 2 weekends, maybe 30 to 40 hours of actual working time. And I am by no means a professional builder by any standpoint or by any means of the word, but I was able to put it together pretty easily. And I did a few modifications to make it more sturdy so that it doesn't fly away during hurricane season here in Virginia. But I went through kind of a picture by picture, step by step way of doing it. If you have any questions, you can always go ahead and ask, but I'm gonna go ahead and start going through exactly how I put up my new Harbor Freight greenhouse. To get started, the first thing I had to do was decide where I would put the greenhouse. And after some deliberation, decided to put it on the side of my property towards the back, actually next to my compost pile. So we may be doing some passive heating here in the future. We will see. So I went ahead with my flat spade and just took off that soil. They recommend going, I think, 5 inches down, and I was right around there. You want to try to get it as flat as possible, but when you start going, it definitely just becomes a task you just want to get done. So I got that done. Once I got all of it kind of spaded out, I went ahead and leveled it as good as I could. Now, I did not go ahead and dig it all the way down at this point. You can actually see there's kind of a raised section there. I wasn't 100% sure what I was going to be doing floor-wise, but I would say if you do know, get that taken out now. It will save you a lot of headache. Next, we went ahead and laid down the base plate and then bolted it together. That was pretty self-explanatory. At that point, you just want to make sure that you've got enough space dug out where you're going to be able to set that nice and solidly. And then next, went ahead and added the sliding base pieces that are going to be helping us attach the sides and front and back to the greenhouse. Next, went ahead and added on the triangle pieces. Now, this is where things start getting a little bit trickier. You're going to want to make sure that you just hand tighten. Do not over tighten or use a ratchet or a wrench, because you are going to be undoing these bolts probably 3 to 4 times depending on where they are. So even these front ones, make sure you just hand tighten them, because they will be coming undone and put back on multiple times. Next, I went ahead and added the top frame piece, and towards the back, I think it's part 48. You're gonna really wanna make sure that you put that in correctly, because I undid it and redid it about 5 times before I had it in there correct. So really read that part of the directions. And next, we went ahead and just started adding on our top pieces that we're going to be attaching the roof to. And so this is when the directions, I will say, started to get a bit tricky to read. They were still okay, but there was some gray area where I kind of had to figure it out myself. So really try to figure out those directions and use this as a good template if you need to. Next is the part that would have been helpful to have a few extra hands, but I was doing it myself and was able to get that top pinnacle of that roof up, but it was definitely not the easiest thing I did throughout the process. And if you're wondering why the tarp is out, that was actually, this was over the course of a few days and we had quite a bit of rain, and I knew I did not want to have to deal with muddy ground while I was on top of the ladder. So I ended up going ahead and getting the whole frame, stick part of the frame, put together. And next, I had to take a trip over to the hardware store, and I picked up some screws. Now, these are self-tapping with a black band around them to make them watertight. And then I picked up some tape. Now, this is just HVAC tape, and the key with it is really just going to help cap off the top of that polycarbonate plastic so that water can't run down and create one of the biggest complaints that people have, and that is actual discoloration, which would happen after a few years. So this way we can kind of get ahead of it. So I did that with all of the pieces. I kind of just would get as many pieces that I needed and put it together, and with the tape. And I will say that the door was one of the harder things to put together. Two hands better than one there, or two people better than one. But I was able to put it together, and
got the door together, and once you start putting on this polycarbonate, you're really going to want to make sure that you finish it, because you get a few pieces on and some of them catch, they might be a mile down the road and you will not see them ever again. So make sure that you start and finish that in a timely manner with that polycarbonate. And something that I did not do correctly is you're going to want to start at one end, whether that is the back or the front of the greenhouse, when you're putting this roof together. And then you're going to, then you can kind of get up on the ladder, screw some pieces in. But how I did it was I put all of the moving window pieces together, which created a bit of a bottleneck when I was trying to get the middle pieces done. And so that was a problem that could have easily been avoided by just starting either in the front or the back of the roof and then continuing on as you go. Now, you may be able to notice from there, I did go ahead and add in those screws on each joint piece. And then as I was up there, I went ahead and added the wiggle wire or the little metal clips to go ahead and secure it. Because I will say, once you get that roof done, it is very hard to do anything towards the top. It is a very tall ceiling to this greenhouse. The greenhouse, after the first weekend or the first couple of days, was finally finished. The polycarbonate was on, the base was done, but I was still a bit worried. I had the doors on, but I was still a bit worried that it could still blow away because there was really nothing holding it to the ground. So my next step was to go ahead and rip apart some 4x4s and dig some holes with my post hole digger and lay those in. And this was a part, I used this as the base to my benches, so I was very conscious of that. If you're not doing the benches like I did it, you can always just set those 4x4s right down to the top of that base plate and you'll get just as good of sturdiness. But I was able to use those 4x4s to secure my benches as well. So I dug the hole out, went ahead and then put the post in and got it to the right height that I wanted. I kind of had it at, I think it was 2 feet off the base there of the ground, or off the base level once I had the floor finished, and then went ahead and added that to all the sides. And I went ahead and added 8-foot 4x4s to the back of my greenhouse because that is where I was going to be doing a double decker workbench and also a growing area. So a little bit taller there, doesn't really add much more stability unless you were to screw that in at the top, which is also a great idea. So I had those in, went ahead and mixed some cement and then just put it on in the holes. I let that sit for a couple of hours before I did anything else, and then went ahead and just covered it over with some dirt because I was leveling out that floor. I wanted to get it nice and level, and at this point I had decided how I was going to do the base of my greenhouse with some brick and sand, which will be for another video where I go over some more of my extensive modifications. But I went ahead and then took some 3.5-inch screws and screwed the base plate into those 4x4s on all four corners to add quite a bit of stability. And then just really the last step in getting the whole base down was going around all four sides of the greenhouse and adding back some of my soil, which is a nice packed clay. So went ahead and just added it in. I filled it up on the wheelbarrow and then went ahead with just my feet. You can use a shovel, but I stamped it in, really tamped it in there good so that it wasn't going to move, it wasn't going to shift, and so that when I started to do the interior floor, I was able to push up against those sides without having any shifting. So that was how I ended up putting up the greenhouse, a few of the modifications. Stay tuned for another video on the complete modification list that I did for the greenhouse, everything that I added from the benches to the floor to the ceilings, and really just to stabilize it and make it as ergonomical and workable as possible for me in here, starting plants, maybe growing some plants throughout the year. And it will, I'm sure, evolve over the years and over the course of time that I use it, but I really wanted to make sure I got it as sturdy as possible.
Thank you guys so much for watching. If you're interested in more videos from our 1 acre vegan farm, you can find a playlist and you can always subscribe. And then there's always a bunch of whole food plant-based and vegan recipes on YouTube, Facebook, and my website, plantbasedgabriel.com. I am Plant-Based Gabriel. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll hopefully see you in an upcoming video.